Cog, look!
Globally, in 2022, we produced about 37 billion tons of carbon dioxide from fossil fuels and industry. About half of those tons stayed up in the atmosphere. Then about 25% were absorbed by plants and soil. The other 25% were absorbed by Earth's oceans. They capture a lot of carbon dioxide. Our oceans are a huge carbon sink. A carbon sink is anything that absorbs more carbon than it releases. But how do oceans do that? Let's take a closer look. Here's what you'll need. Safety glasses, 1 cup or 250 mils of water, some baking soda, vinegar, bromothymol blue, 0.5%, 2 big cups, a small one, 2 saucers, measuring spoons, a marker, and some tape and a stir stick. Add 12 or more drops of bromothymol blue to the water in a plastic cup. Bromothymol blue is a chemical, a dye, that changes color as a liquid becomes more acidic. Now imagine I've created 2 identical oceans. My tap water is neutral, so it's got a pH of about 7. One ocean will be the control that we use to compare for color change. I'm going to give the other ocean a carbon dioxide-rich atmosphere using the old reliable vinegar and baking soda. Add 1/4 teaspoon or 1.25 milliliters of baking soda. Tape it to the side of my big cup, being very careful not to spill. Now very carefully, add 1 teaspoon or 5 mils of vinegar. Cover each ocean with a plate. Let's watch. We see a color change where the carbon dioxide-rich air meets the water. That yellow-green color means it's getting more acidic. Here's what happened. Baking soda and vinegar made CO2 gas bubbles. As carbon dioxide was absorbed into the water, some of that CO2 reacted with water to form carbonic acid, causing the water to become more acidic. More CO2 in the air resulted in more CO2 in the ocean, making more carbonic acid, making the ocean water more acidic. Measurements show that our ocean water is becoming more acidic in the last 50 years. To be clear, our ocean waters are not acidic, but they do have 30% more acid than they used to. They've captured more CO2 from the air. CO2 absorption into ocean water is just the beginning of the story. Some CO2 is taken up by photosynthetic organisms, like phytoplankton, those microscopic plant-like organisms drifting around in the ocean. Algae and seagrasses photosynthesize too. Altogether, we call them producers because they produce sugars, food, just like the land plants we studied in episode 8 on photosynthesis. But the story continues. In oceans, as on land, food gets eaten. You can call it the food chain or the food web or the food pyramid. An ocean pyramid might look like this. You need a lot of mass at the producer level to feed the upper levels. Only 10% of the food energy in each level is passed on to the next level up. So 10% of the food energy of those producers is passed to animal plankton like krill that consume the producers. Next up is second-order consumers like baleen whales and little fish that eat from the levels beneath them. Then third-order consumers like seals or salmon eat the little fish. And on top, killer whales. Waste or dead organisms from all the levels can be eaten by detritivores or decomposed. That can take a long time in the dark, frigid ocean floor. Whales, for example, are made of tons of carbon. When they die and sink, it takes decades or longer to break down all those carbon-based molecules. You could say whales are carbon sinks that really sink. And whales are a source of ocean treasure, too. If only Cog were here to help us sniff it out. Oh, look, Cog, you found a treasure map. And there's a message, too. I'll read that. Ahoy, me hearties. When it's cold as polar bear toes, get yourself to a winter feeding ground. Then heave-ho, it's out you go, into the briny deep. And thar she blows. The booty will be delivered. Hey, Cog, where are you going? Oh, I see you picked the Alaskan winter feeding grounds. Now, out you go in a little rowboat to wait for the booty. Look, it's a humpback whale, and it's leaving something for you. What is it, Cog? Whale poop? Pew! You really could have sniffed out this treasure. But don't feel bad, Cog. Poop happens, and it really is a treasure. Whales are farmers of the ocean. They fertilize the floating green gardens of phytoplankton by pooping magnificent plumes of nitrogen and iron-rich poop. Phytoplankton need that iron to photosynthesize and to make chlorophyll. Iron is what we call a limiting factor. No more iron, no more phytoplankton population growth. It's a circle. Iron in phytoplankton gets consumed by krill, tiny shrimp-like creatures, who are consumed by whales. And they'll deliver that iron back to the phytoplankton in their poop. More whale poop means more phytoplankton. More phytoplankton means more excess carbon dioxide is captured in photosynthesis. So whale poop is a real treasure for planet Earth. And oceans can store carbon, too. Lots of dead stuff falls to the ocean floor and gets buried by more dead stuff and dirt. All that carbon can be stored for hundreds, thousands, or millions of years. Oceans affect weather and climate other ways, too. Ocean currents distribute heat around the world. Cold ocean water at the poles sinks and travels to the equator, where it is warmed by the sun. The warm water rises, some evaporates. Some of that water vapor forms rain that can be pushed inland
by winds.
Most of the rain on land started in the ocean.
Then,
the warm water from the equators travels back to the poles where it cools, sinks, and the circle continues. The whole system hinges on an interesting property of water. It takes a lot of energy to heat it up. Then, water holds onto that heat for a long time. Let's take a closer look. This air-filled balloon represents our atmosphere. The air inside heats up quickly when I apply this flame, so the balloon melts quickly and pop. Now let's look at this water balloon. It represents our oceans. Water accepts a lot of heat before temperatures start to rise. It takes a long time to see the effects of added energy in the water. This balloon does not melt quickly. Right now, about 90% of the excess heat trapped by carbon dioxide from burning fossil fuels is being absorbed in our oceans. It took a while, but we're starting to see the ocean temperatures rise now. This will affect our weather and climate. So let's recap. Carbon dioxide is absorbed from our atmosphere into our oceans. Ocean producers like phytoplankton turn that carbon dioxide into food that can get passed up the food pyramid and broken down by decomposers. Whale poop provides nutrients to phytoplankton so they can capture carbon dioxide. Ocean organisms that die and fall to the ocean floor can be buried, which stores their carbon for long periods of time. Currently, our oceans are absorbing most of the excess heat that's being trapped by excess greenhouse gases from fossil fuels. In this episode, we looked at how oceans and ocean life store carbon. In episode 10, we're going to look high and low to find carbon sinks in stone homes.